Rita Bahuguna Joshi, Congress leader and spokesperson, and Siddharthnath Singh of the BJP, Rahul Nardekar of the NCP, and my first question is to Kumar Ketkar, senior journalist. Mr. Ketkar, you think if it carries on like this, the Congress will start breaking up?
Congress can break up, but I don't know whether Congress will break up, because you're required to break up. Two-thirds of the people break up.
No, at individual state levels, you know, the people are frustrated.
No, that is different. That breakup will happen.
Will happen, you think?
Yeah. That break can happen.
So state units will start breaking up.
No, state units breaking up and party breaking up are two different things. Mm. But the point is, you are saying that this is the worst crisis is emergency.
Yeah.
According to me, it is worse even than that worst crisis of emergency. Because 43 seats is just a horrible scenario which they never thought will happen. And they don't want to
blame. So what are they going to do?
No,
I mean, they're going to sit there and...
The question is not, Mr. Paul, you're saying that no blame game, but somebody has to take the responsibility.
Who is that somebody?
My simple question is, Rahul Gandhi will have to take the responsibility. Rahul Gandhi should have resigned and said, I will remain MP. I will remain a Congress
but
worker.
But then Rahul Gandhi is scared that if he resigns, he's never going to come back.
Vice President.
He's scared. You lose the chair.
No,
nobody
I don't
wants
know
to
he's scared or not, but he should have said, I am accountable, because he demands accountability, that I am not resigning from the party. I am not giving up work. I will remain Member of Parliament, but I will resign from the post of the Vice President.
Because
he was in charge. And just tell me one thing. According to him as well as the party, if the party got enough number of seats and the Prime Minister's name was to be proposed, then Rahul Gandhi was to become Prime Minister.
Yeah.
Now, when they have lost, would it not be proper for him to become the leader of the CPP, that is Congress Parliamentary Party? Because there is no question of leader of opposition, because they haven't got the
10%. I think what's going on here is that Rahul Gandhi is engineering this...
Rahul Gandhi is engineering.
I think people like Milind Deora are very close to Rahul Gandhi. People like Priya Dutt are on the right side of Rahul Gandhi. And I think this is orchestrated by Rahul Gandhi, that, you know, start saying that people around me are bad.
You are very intelligent, and that's why you think there is some orchestration possible. In Congress at present, there is no coordination, there is no orchestration, and there is no command system. Congress has lost the communication strategy internally before they lost it outside.
And so this is then therefore open revolt. Then what you're saying is open.
It is not open revolt, it is open discontent.
Discontent.
Yeah.
Okay. Siddharthnath Singh, how are you viewing it? I mean, every day this is breaking up. Do you think Rahul Gandhi is orchestrating this, or do you think he's seriously coming under criticism? You must be very pleased with this flow of developments over the last few days. But beyond that, I mean, by the way, I think we lost the line.
Already the results.
We try and get it back. Yes.
Well, Arnab, I'm not going to be one of those who will say it's their internal business. And so
I would not like
to comment. But I would say that I will not say that, because it concerns as an Indian that we should have a strong opposition, and therefore Congress being the oldest party and as a national party is being disseminated at the level where they are, they need to be having a serious introspection. And what I see as a politician or a political activist, that there are young voices which are coming out in Congress party, because they have a huge stake in the party. They have a longevity to go in politics. There are certain older Congress leaders who will like to say that these things should not be spoken, because they don't have that much of a stake. So Milind or Priya Dutt or anybody, they have at least 25 years, 30 years to go in politics. So they are expressing their concern. There are serious concerns in the Congress. Communication is a huge issue. Number of Congress MPs say we cannot reach out to Rahul Gandhi. Their way, if we dial them, then you hear, press one number to talk to Rahul Gandhi, press two to reach out to the secretary. So that kind of things are being spoken. And what Milind has said, Arnab, is a serious pointer to the Congress party, not to the government. He said the buck stops with the party. The party could have stopped. Party cannot be sitting idle and not checking what the government is doing. So he's taken the entire blame to the party rather than the government, which was some of the old guards of Congress were trying to protect.
It's an unreal situation.
Was the government's problem and government was not communicating.
No, you see, it's an unreal situation. It is unbelievable now what is happening. Rita Bahuguna Joshi, the light's a little dim there, but I hope you can hear me. Ms. Joshi, this is a very serious question.
Lights are dim.
Please do not presume that I or any journalist is enjoying the plight of the Congress party. But I just want to tell you what people are, your own people are saying about your own leaders, the Gandhis. Your leaders, this is not even media, they are saying your leaders don't, Gandhis don't talk. They don't communicate. Your leaders are saying that the Gandhis are disconnected. That the Gandhis are in their own world. That the Gandhis are surrounded by psycho fans. Your own leaders are saying all this, that the party is not a party, it has become a cabal essentially. That's what your leaders are saying. Terrible situation, you see, Miss Joshi. But what can be worse is if you are in denial of this. These are your own people saying this now, you see. It's a terrible situation. What are you going to do?
Can I speak?
Yeah,
now?
Yeah, please.
You see, there is no doubt about it that we have had a very serious setback. And it was unimaginable. We had not anticipated this drubbing. And therefore, there is a lot of thinking going on at different levels within the party. Some people are voicing it within the party. Some people are doing it outside. The younger group is speaking. I heard them today. But this is the same leadership which brought us into power.
See,
in
that 2004. Is the problem. That is the
in
problem.
In 2009.
That is
in 2000. One second.
This is exactly again. You start the
so
protect Gandhi strategy.
One second.
Again, you've begun
they
the
cannot,
protect Gandhi.
No, there cannot
movement.
Be a very simplest.
Why are you
Mr.
doing this?
Wait, Mr. Arnab.
Why
there is no
this?
Simplistic explanation of this defeat, if you coin it, only on the leaders. See, this is escapism. If I say
so
it's only
all
because
the people
of the
leader, are escapists.
In 2009,
so
in
all
2009,
your leaders are escapists.
When we said, you tell me when Atalji was leading the NDA and they lost in 2004,
yeah,
who
I'm
said it was
Atalji's
defeat
see,
in BJP?
This is the problem.
When they lost in 2009,
this is the problem.
Who said
I'm trying to draw you
the,
into
it was the defeat of Advani.
You know this whole business. What happens is that you come
the leadership
and
leadership has taken the responsibility.
No. One second. What people are saying is
Mrs. Gandhi and Rahulji have claimed the responsibility as leaders
what
of
saying?
The party.
No. One second.
But you can't say they're the only reason.
No, Miss Joshi.
How can it be? How can
Miss Miss Joshi? Be open today. Miss Joshi, please listen. No, Miss Joshi, those days are gone today. Those days are gone today, given the horrible situation which the Congress party is in, that you can afford to be deaf to what people are telling you. And Rahul Narvekar wants to give you some sage advice. Rahul Narvekar, please. Yes, Ms. Narvekar.
Well, if you're discussing the controversy with regards to the statement made by Milind Deora, who happens to be the member of parliament of an ally party, other than that, he's also a former member of parliament,
former member
also
of
a
parliament.
Good friend.
Yeah.
And what I have known
come
of
to
this,
the point, Rahul.
What I have known of this young politician is he's always been candid. Whether it was a 2611 attack where he came down heavily on his own government in the state, he's been candid. When there are faults with the government, when there are faults within the party, he's voiced that. But that does not at all imply that there is any kind of discontent within the Congress party. I don't think we should read too much into it. He's been candid. He accepts the difficulties. He accepts the
problem
faults.
With the Congress
and,
party
and,
is that
and
is
let
the
me
problem
tell you,
the problem
only
with
a
the Congress
person,
party.
Yeah. One minute. Only
this
a person.
This
only a
problem.
Person who accepts his faults can rectify them and come out.
Arre, don't give me philosophy. Don't give me philosophy on the program.
The problem,
this is the news hour.
The problem with news hour is every statement will be twisted. Every statement will be turned to give it a political color. But I'll tell you, your viewers are also tired of it. They also realize that when an honest young politician makes a candid statement, it shouldn't be read otherwise.
So you're saying it's not good, it's not healthy
and not in the interest of young people who want to enter politics that when they are candid, they'll be picked upon. When they're honest, they'll
himself.
Be pulled up and they'll be brought
himself.
Into controversy.
Man is not proved
I don't
himself.
Think I don't think you should do that.
Man has failed to prove himself.
Arnab, that is not fair.
That's
that is really not fair.
I am not here to be fair to politicians. The man has failed to prove himself, yes or no?
Why is he fool? Why should he come and prove anything to you? He
really?
Said what he wanted to. His party has got the message loud and clear. The people have understood him. Why should
you,
he give you any clarification?
Why are you embarrassing your party chief Sharad Pawar on a live TV program?
I don't understand this vague statement of yours.
I don't make any vague statement.
My party chief is way above these silly comments by any journalist or by any news anchor. He's way above that. He does not get embarrassed by such statements.
I have to get back to Rahul Narvekar on that point. Mr. Niketkar, I'm coming to you. You see, Mr. Narvekar, I told you that Rahul Gandhi has not proved himself and you all went into a tizzy. Please remember.
I never said that.
Please remember. No, I'm telling Narvekar. Mr. Narvekar, at 3:35 p.m., in a comment on October 25th, 2013, Sharad Pawar said that Rahul Gandhi has not proved himself. I repeated what Sharad Pawar said.
So, what relevance does that have with this controversy?
Why don't you ask Rahul? Why don't you ask Sharad Pawar?
What relevance does it have with this controversy?
Why don't you ask Sharad Pawar? He was talking about Rahul Gandhi.
Honorable Pawar Sahib has mentioned at the relevant time what he...
Now you are stuttering.
Honorable Pawar Sahib has said whatever was relevant at that point of time.
Now you have nothing to say.
I have said what I have to. You are trying to confuse your viewers.
No,
you are trying to mix two different issues, which are not going to succeed at. So, Mr. Arnab Goswami, you can try some new trick.
See, the problem of being an apologist for the Congress party is that sometimes you end up embarrassing your own party.
First and foremost, I don't think anyone needs to give any kind of apology to you in the least.
No, I'm saying you're being an apologist for the Congress party.
Therefore, Arnab Goswami, don't give yourself this undue importance that people are going to come and apologize to you or anyone.
I'm saying you're being an apologist for the Congress party.
Not at all. Why should I? See, what happens within the Congress party is the least of my business.
Why are you getting worked up?
It's not my business at all. But I'm just pointing out this bad habit of some people to make controversies out of a non-issue.
Are we discussing?
This is not fair.
You know, anyway, I'm coming to you, Siddharth Nath Singh. You see, the problem is there's a lot of people who
sort of provide this, you know, self-serving insulation around Mr. Rahul Gandhi, and Mr. Rahul Gandhi may try end up believing that they are correct and the whole world is wrong.
Arnab, I made Ketkar. A point that yes. Rahul Gandhi should resign from the vice president's post, remain MP and work as a Congress activist among the people, and because he was to become prime minister, in case the party had the majority, then now he should become CPP leader. That apart, the charge that Milind and Priyanka and Priyadatta and others have made is against the advisors. Also against the advisors of Rahul, has any advisor ever made a presence either on the channels or made a statement that what they were advising, or have they even had a remorse?
No,
they have not made a comment, and yet they were advising.
I think Rahul Gandhi and the people, names are known and they have not said a word so far,
after coming under attack from their own senior member like Milind Deora. Advisors are under attack. Advisor should make a statement.
But then Rahul Gandhi is possessive about these advisors. He likes them
Rahul Gandhi also should make a statement. Then Rahul Gandhi should say, advisors are not responsible, I am responsible.
Why, he's not.
But he should say something.
Ms. Joshi, what are you going to do? Your party is breaking up in Assam. Your allies are moving away. The NC doesn't want to have a relationship with you. The NCP is slowly going to move away. And the IUML has already started speaking out against you. In Assam, the AUDF has already said it will support the Modi government. You have your party is breaking up from inside, and whoever is there among your allies are beginning to move out. Now, what is this? Are you going to simply sit there, watch, and say, let's go into this self-destruct
mode? Indian politics is all about alignments and realignments, but the question here is...
No, where's the realignment? It's all...
will finally be together.
It's all de-alignment. There's no realignment. It's de-alignment.
A statement here and there...
De-alignment.
A statement here and there does not mean that the alliance is breaking up.
This is the problem.
The statement here and there does not mean that we are hostile to each other. These are candid talks which are coming out, and as far as I know, whether it was Milind or it is Priyadat, they are very close to Rahulji. And they interacted with him a lot.
This is the problem.
So what they made was not an attack, but a statement. They made a statement, and the party and the government, our former government, we know where the lapses are. We don't have to discuss it with you on a panel.
No, we want to know.
We know. It is blatantly. We see. We are watching. We are seeing.
It's a party that has governed the country. How can you be so arrogant that I say I will not discuss anything on TV?
We are not arrogant. We understand the situation. We know it was a rejection. It was a rejection of the UPA government. It was not a rejection so much of the leader.
You governed the country for 10 years. We have a right to ask you today what went wrong and why is your leadership gone into this time warp?
I'm telling you.
And the problem has been with the Congress party, if I may say so. I'll tell you one thing. There is one of these people who is in this group, for example, who has no political experience. He's some lateral entry from an Ivy League university. He knows nothing about politics. You ask him a straight and tough question, and he says, here you are, you're a right winger. I personally experienced this with one of these people. You ask them a straight question, he says, oh, you're a right winger. You don't agree with the NAC, you don't agree with the Congress Party, you're a right winger. Miss Joshi, do you realize that these people have sunk you? You are sinking because of these people.
Let me make a comment. How many hundreds of people were behind Mr. Modi's campaign? How they campaigned right or wrong?
This is again,
how they targeted the government very responsibly? They
denial will not do.
Out of untruth. Untruth. I'm asking, did you ever question them? Did you ever bring them to a forum to ask them?
I don't know, ma'am.
You doing as a non-politician behind Modi? Why are you... They were determining the agenda for the campaign of Mr. Modi.
No, well, anyway, I don't think...
Coming. How Lodi estate became the center of strategizing for Modi's campaign? What he would speak?
Well, they have delivered and you have not. There's a big difference. You have lost and they have won. I mean, what is the problem?
You're not asking those questions to them.
No, no.
Why aren't you asking these questions to the apolitical people?
This is the problem is that, ma'am, I'll tell you one thing. You can muzzle dissent. You can muzzle dissent inside the party. But people are watching you outside. Yes, Siddharth.
Arnab, let me clarify to Rita ji that Modi ji's campaign was also run by some volunteers. But at the end of the day, and my own personal experience I'm giving, whenever Modi ji came to Bengal, where I was the looking after, whatever was being spoken, it was bounced with us. And I looked into it and we said yes and no. For him to, you know, either in his oratory to use it. So there was always a political content in his campaign.
Siddharth,
for example, in UP, it was Amit Shah who was advising him.
There was a huge political content and political activists who were supporting the system. BJP's campaign, the leadership of the BJP was not involved. The leadership of the RSS not involved. RSS sent volunteers everywhere, but BJP was not involved. I can tell you by directly quoting BJP leadership. In fact, they were so frustrated.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ketkar.
They were so... Siddharth ji, just go and inquire in your party. There was no revolt in the party, but there was widespread discontent among the BJP leadership and among the BJP karyakartas because Narendra Modi had got hired event managers and propaganda teams which were not necessarily part of the BJP or RSS. They were working from outside. There were also people from United States management companies and all those, they were not the BJP karyakartas. So don't try to say that every time this is correct on part of Modi because he has won. Modi has won for several reasons. I don't want to go into
Mr.
that.
Mr. Ketkar,
against the wishes of the BJP.
Mr. Ketkar, if your sermon is over, may I speak? Mr. Ketkar and Rita ji, you both are speaking at cross purposes. But let me answer Mr. Ketkar because he was louder than you. Mr. Ketkar, we are not in a denial. We got great help from various organizations, including RSS. And Piyush there was
Goyal
a reason when they came
record.
Out to help.
Piyush Goyal was
and everybody, every organization has a right
got,
to help. So don't feel anything
than,
bad.
More than
it's a part of the strategy. We did
independently
it. We delivered it.
No connection with BJP.
But that strategy
that's
was worked
that's
out.
No, but that's
not by those who don't communicate.
The question
it's a strategy which was worked out.
All I'm saying is,
the BJP was not by the BJP.
I say this again. If the Congress party has decided that everybody else is wrong, they are right, all voters are wrong. They can tell the people of this country. They can tell the voters
and
who are all wrong.
Mr. Ketkar.
We are all right. And Akbar Road is right and the rest of India is wrong. We're taking the debate forward. I actually would have expected a different tone from the Congress party tonight, but I'm not finding it. I'll see in a few minutes whether that tone changes.